This tutorial covers how to submit 2021 data in our online data portal to be recognized in 2022 for the Outpatient Recognition Program Check Change Control Cholesterol. Log into the data platform at aha.infosarioregistry.com/login using the username and password sent to you via email after registering. Pause here to review further details on screen now regarding how to register your organization and get a user account. You will submit data through Program Form. Click either the icon under Get Started or the link in the left navigation panel. If your organization has submitted in the past, you may have existing forms under the Edit Forms section, like I do here. Each date represents the calendar year from which that data was collected. For 2022 recognition, you'll need to submit a 2021 form. You or another member of your organization may have already started entering your 2021 data for recognition, so check if you already have a 2021 program form for Check Change Control Cholesterol. If so, you can click that and start adding data. You can see I have a 2021 form for another program, Target BP, already. I don't have a 2021 form yet for Check Change Control Cholesterol, so I'm going to click Add New next to that program. I'm submitting for 2022 recognition, which is based on 2021 data. I'll type 2021 into the reporting year field. Hit Submit to start the form. Check Change Control Cholesterol has two tabs of data to enter, which you can see under Tabs on the right. The first tab, Participant Information, contains questions about your healthcare organization. To be eligible for 2022 recognition, you will need to fill in all questions, including the number of providers, a new question asking for a breakdown of race and ethnicity, a breakdown of your patients by payer group, and questions surveying your use of the ASCVD risk score. You must answer yes on question 10 to be eligible for recognition. The gray boxes on questions 5 and 6 can't be edited. They auto-populate to total the number of patients entered above. That's because the patient breakdown by race and ethnicity, as well as the patient breakdown by payer, must equal your total patient population given in question 3. Two includes the measure and denominator and numerator questions that will determine your measure performance and award status. Note, filling out both tabs, participant information and measure submission, is required for any recognition, including participant status. Once all fields are complete and no errors are detected, the data entry complete checkbox becomes available on the participant information tab. Check this box to mark that you are finished entering data, and then save. You can save or save and exit and come back at any time to revise your data. A snapshot of all data in the platform, complete or incomplete, is taken at the date and time of the recognition deadline, but you can revise your data at any point up until the snapshot time. Let's start entering our data. Before you begin, make sure the data you submit is representative of the healthcare organization you're currently viewing. Look left under Currently Viewing or at the top right to orient yourself. I recommend having the data collection worksheet available or filling it out ahead of time for ease. You can find this worksheet by navigating to the library on the left. I'm right-clicking to open in a new tab. In the library, click on Check Change Control Cholesterol Data Collection Worksheet to download the PDF. The worksheet contains additional guidance on how to answer each question, especially for question 6, which asks for that patient breakdown by their primary payer. Questions may change from year to year, so please ensure you have the latest data collection worksheet, which you can find by looking at the top of the first page. Let's go back to the program form. Here, you can also use the official measure specifications, which can be opened directly from the program form by going to the Measure Submission tab and clicking the Measure Description link for MIPS Measure 438 Statin Therapy. I'm right-clicking to open in a new tab to have on hand if needed. Back to the program form now. Let's return to the Participant Information tab to get started. The first question asks if your organization diagnoses and manages patients with high cholesterol, up to and including prescribing medications. A yes response is required to be eligible for a 2022 award. The second question requires you to certify that the attestations entered in the form are accurate to the best of your knowledge. A yes response is also required here to be eligible for a 2022 award. Question 3 asks for the total adult patient population, ages 18 and above, who had an office visit in 2021 for your organization. When pulling data for this question, make sure you are saving this query and can further break down the same patient population by race and ethnicity and by payer group. My demo organization has 37,155 patients, ages 18 and above. For question 4, input how many providers your healthcare organization has. We are looking for all physicians, nurse practitioners, and physician assistants in your outpatient organization. My demo organization has 85 providers. In question 5, we ask for a breakdown of how your total adult patient population, ages 18 years and older, self-identify by race and ethnicity. This question is based on Table 3B of the HRSA Uniform Data System Reporting Requirements for 2021 Health Center data. The same question appears in our Target BP and Target Type 2 Diabetes program forms, so you may already have this information available. All fields must contain a value. Please enter a 0 where there are no patients. Here is the data that I have. If there are patients who have not disclosed their race and ethnicity, you can put them under the unreported, unknown total patient count. Once all the fields are filled in, an automatic total of what you have entered populates in the gray box at the bottom. This box must equal your answer to question 3. For question 6, take your total adult patient population given in question 3 and break it down by the patient's primary payer. Not sure which group is considered your patient's primary payer? Use the guidance on the last page of the data collection worksheet for questions. Here's the data that I have for providers and payers. If you're still not sure on some patients' payer groups, put them under the other unknown category. Once all the fields are filled in, an automatic total of what you have entered populates in the gray box at the bottom. This box must equal your answer to question 3. If it does not, say if I change my other public patients from 1,326 to 0, an error will appear at question 3. Because this is a red error, I won't be able to save. For red errors like this one, I can delete one of the fields that's contributing to my subtotal to make the error disappear. This allows me to save and come back later once I have identified the error in my data. However, all fields must be filled in to be eligible for recognition. So, in order to fully fix this, I must eventually either revise my question 3 or my payer group totals so that they match up. Questions 7 through 10 ask about your organization's use of ASCVD risk estimation and treatment plan for very high-risk patients. ASCVD stands for atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease. The American Heart Association advocates for ASCVD risk estimation tools, which enable healthcare providers and patients to estimate 10-year and lifetime risk for atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease, or denote very high-risk patients for secondary prevention. Question 7 asks if your organization calculates risk for ASCVD. If yes, follow-up questions appear asking if the calculation is performed within your EHR or outside of the EHR. If you pick the third option, my organization does not calculate or document ASCVD risk, it will automatically change your overall answer to no. My demo organization calculates ASCVD risk within our EHR. Question 8 asks if your organization documents the ASCVD risk score. If yes, where? A discrete field in the EHR, meaning its own standalone field, or in a notes section or other non-discrete field in the EHR. If you pick the third option, my organization does not calculate or document ASCVD risk, it will automatically change your overall answer to no. My demo organization documents our risk score in a general notes field, not in its own specific field. Question 9 is a new question. It's asking if your organization operationalizes a specific treatment plan for managing patients considered very high risk for future ASCVD events. If you answer yes, we'll ask for more details about what that plan includes. Note that you must answer these follow-up questions. Leaving these unanswered generates a red critical error, which will prevent you from saving your form. My organization's treatment plan includes the detailed collection of past medical history and educating care teams every 12 months. Question 10 asks if your organization is committed to continuously improving use and data capture of ASCVD risk estimations. You must answer yes to be eligible for an award. Selecting no generates a note that tells me I'm ineligible for an award. Keep in mind, you can answer no to questions 7 through 9 and still be eligible for recognition, as long as you say yes on question 10, indicating that you are committed to improving. Make sure to save as you go. The final two questions are housed in the Measure Submission tab. This can be accessed by clicking the blue icon with four lines. Questions 11 and 12 are used to calculate your organization's performance on the measure and your subsequent award status. Question 11 is the denominator of the MIPS 438 measure. This denominator asks for patients who had an office visit in 2021 and who are considered at high risk for a cardiovascular event under the American College of Cardiology and American Heart Association guidelines. Using MIPS 438 logic, which can again be found in the measure description link, how many patients fall into any of these three risk groups? Note that though it says or between each group, you are not picking a single group for your denominator. You are analyzing your patient population to determine all patients who fall into one or more of these risk groups. When calculating, you can determine how many patients are in each risk group and provide the sum of all three. But be careful not to double count patients who fall into more than one risk group. Make sure to save this end result of patients so you can calculate your numerator. The risk groups are number 1, patients age 21 or above as of January 1st, 2021 with a clinical ASCVD diagnosis. 2, patients age 21 or above as of January 1st, 2021 who have ever had a fasting or direct lab result of an LDL cholesterol level of 190 milligrams per deciliter or higher, or who were previously diagnosed with or currently have an active diagnosis of familial or pure hypercholesterolemia. 3, patients age 40 to 75 years as of January 1st, 2021 with type 1 or type 2 diabetes and with an LDL cholesterol level of 70 to 189 milligrams per deciliter as their highest fasting or direct lab test result in the measurement year or during the 2 years prior to the beginning of the measurement period. Make sure to exclude certain patients from all calculations based on the measure requirements, such as patients who are pregnant or breastfeeding. Question 12 is the numerator of the measure. Of the patients who fell into the denominator, question 11, how many were prescribed or were actively using statins in 2021? Time to enter my answers to questions 11 and 12. My demo facility had 1,901 patients in the above risk groups. You can see that an additional question has appeared. This won't appear for everyone. It popped up for me because my answer represented less than 6% of my total patient population that I gave back in question 3, Because it's unusual for such a small segment of patients to be in any of these risk groups, we need to know a little more about how you pulled this data. Question 13 asks if you determined your risk group patients based on a sampling or subset of patients rather than the full population. If yes, question 14 appears and asks for a brief description of your sampling method and reason for sampling. If you did not sample, question 15 appears instead, requesting that you double check the measure logic. Remember, the denominator represents patients in all of these risk groups, not just one. If your query was correct, let us know why your organization's population might be unique. Please note, if these additional questions appear, to be eligible for an award, you must either 1. Revise your denominator data to be more than 6% of your total population, or 2. You must answer all of the new questions to the best of your ability. For my demo organization, I didn't sample, but after double-checking my measure logic, I realized I had incorrectly calculated one of the risk groups. My real denominator is 7,889. Finally, of my 7,889 at-risk patients, 5,350 were prescribed or using statins. Once all fields have been entered and you've confirmed you've said yes to question 10 to be eligible for an award, the last step in our submission process is to check the data entry complete box. An important note, if this checkbox cannot be populated, it means your data is incomplete and you may not be eligible for recognition. Please review both tabs and ensure no fields are left unanswered before exiting. I am unable to check the box. Scrolling through my questions, I can see it is because I left the other public patient count for question 9 blank. Now that is corrected, I am able to check the data entry complete box. This ensures that I am ready for recognition. Finally, I'll click Save and Exit. Back under Program Forms, I now have a Save 2021 form for Check Change Control Cholesterol. You can go back and edit your data at any time before the recognition deadline. Recognition is based on a snapshot of all data in the portal, captured at a specific moment in time. As long as your data is entered and complete by that time, you are eligible for recognition. Look out for regular newsletters and additional communications from us to learn more about recognition. Thank you for choosing to submit data for Check Change Control Cholesterol. If you have additional questions, please contact us at bit.ly/AQContactUs, or if you need help logging in, you can contact our platform vendor using the email address on screen now.